What is that?
It's days until I die.
Okay, tell me a bit more.
I've been interested in tech ever since I was a kid. I used to attend conferences mainly focused on youth and getting involved.
When I started to make projects or do things that were helping people, it was a lot more satisfying and fulfilling as a person.
Working on projects with them is just great, talking to people with like-mindedness and, yeah, just working for the greater good.
And I think one thing that really stuck out to me about these kids is they actually thought differently than all these other people.
They know what they're going after and there's no stopping them.
What we're trying to do is provide every single person on this planet with internet access.
We're trying to put connectivity back in the hands of people to do great things. Really, right now, what we're focused on is this big mission of how do we get everyone information?
People in developing countries don't have access to education, but if we're able to provide them with infrastructure, provide them with access to internet, that's one step forward.
How can these people with cellular network who only use their devices for communication now access the internet and the library of knowledge?
There's a couple of companies that are trying to do something similar. Like most famous examples, Elon Musk trying to put satellites in space. There's Google putting balloons in the sky.
You're not scared that you're basically going up against these massive companies?
Maybe we're naive, but I like it. I like going up against them. Why not? This digital gap of information is getting larger and larger every day. So what we thought is like, that shouldn't be a thing. Like, that doesn't make sense to us. Let's solve it.
Let's open up the app. Hotspot. We're sending a text and we're able to retrieve an entire web page. And all we're doing is just displaying it for you and making it easy.
And someone who has texting every month but doesn't have data or anything else can now actually use this and they can access the internet.
Every single search costs around a third of a cent. Third of a cent, yeah. If you're in sub-Saharan Africa, all you gotta do is send a text message. There you have it. Yeah. You can actually interact with the web page as well. That's what we're allowing. Yeah.
The main value proposition of the app is just it's a lot more intuitive versus a text message.
Yeah.
It's an amazing concept, but thinking about it, you realize that there is a need for it and why, how come only 18, 17 year olds came up with it?
Growing up, no one I talked to was like this. No one wanted to do anything I wanted to do. No one wanted to just sit down and like build stuff.
I think with them and with other young people, if you're driven, if you're curious, find your tribe.
We found each other, and I'm grateful to have found it earlier rather than later.
Passion and opportunity. If more people can focus on those two areas and combining them together, I think we'll be able to get more amazing ideas and results like HotSpot.
Why is it that people in like first world nations like Canada or America have all this access to information, but imagine everywhere else in the world had the same amount of access, what the world could be like at an innovation standpoint. We could be 10x where we are today.
What the internet is democratized information. And that's what we should be providing to everyone in the world.
So we're gonna do whatever it takes to get to there. And if that means a lot of pivots, it means a lot of pivots.
Canadian life expectancy is 83, which means I have 23,320 days to live. This really reminds you, do something big before you're gone.